Popping everybody.
What's up?
It's been a damn minute. What is this? Episode like 40, like 1, 42, something like that. It's crazy. This could be one of the last in this scenery.
Yeah, the end of the basement era.
Bittersweet as fuck, yeah.
This kinda year was bittersweet.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, not really as much sweet, but more bitter.
Most part.
There's I'm trying to think. Was there any sweet parts at all?
Sweet parts.
Maybe the change in a lot of people's attitudes towards gratefulness.
Yeah. Makes people appreciate, definitely.
But like,
everyone appreciates.
It really wasn't a lot.
Yeah, but you just gotta look for it.
Is there any good that came out of this year at all? Like,
I feel like once you look for it and you kind of look around and you're like, all right, there's some things that.
I guess it's how you interpret it. You know, 2020 was a good year for some because they weren't put in like a hard
situation.
Like, think about parents who were paying for their kids and then they got laid off. Like, that's one of the worst case scenarios. Yeah.
But we're leaving all that in the past. In the past, 2021.
We're going to keep that in the past.
Yeah, 2021.
We're going to bring that with us.
Yeah. We can learn from it, though. We can learn from it. But 2021. Yeah.
2021 will definitely be like a recovery year, I feel like.
Oh, yeah, dude.
A lot of people.
It's going to be the roaring fucking 20s. Like, because after 2020, it's just everything's uphill. Has to be.
It was in 1920 after the Great Depression.
That's right.
Everything was uphill after that.
I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but the Spanish flu was in the 1910s, right?
Something like that.
In between 1910 and 1920? Or it might have been the decade.
Something around there. It's like every 100 years, there's this major sickness.
Yeah.
You know?
And that's not, like, that's not a coincidence either.
No, I know.
It's
the bacteria and viruses.
Ooh, 1918 to 1920, so right after.
Ooh.
Right after.
That's crazy.
Roaring 20s, right after.
Yeah.
Hey.
I guess it just depends on how long Corona wants to stick around, really.
Yeah, or if we go into another lockdown, which I don't really think.
I don't think America will.
I mean,
I wouldn't doubt it.
I don't feel like Americans are disappointed enough.
That'd be bad if they were.
Yeah, a lot would. Yeah, that would be pretty bad.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys heard about this, but I heard the IRS is going to increase like
the stimmy,
and they're going to increase tax audits on small businesses by like 50%.
What?
Or I think it'd be 150% since they're increasing it.
What?
But
wait,
yeah,
what the?
I forget who posted it, but I saw
like small business. Like, what do you?
Yeah,
Wait, why are they just trying to bone small businesses?
I know, that's what I'm saying. Like, if anything, they should give them cut them a little break.
Yeah, nah, there's no way because the IRS.
America
loves small
runs
businesses.
On small businesses because that supports a lot, like a large majority of the economy.
Yeah,
I think that's a big reason why so much money has been like funneled to like the big corporations like Amazon is because
Costco, Walmart.
Yeah, without the small businesses, I mean, it takes away the competition from the big dogs.
Mm-hmm.
So,
damn, yeah, that's crazy, dude. But 2021 gonna be fire. Getting down new crib, and then you're gonna come down for a potty down there. That'd be
For sure.
Dude, I can't wait.
I'll catch a little flight.
Dude,
just hop on a jet.
It's like 3 hours.
Just say, I mean, shit, I might just load up the PJ with some.
Load up the PJ, okay.
With some jet fuel, and then I'm there.
Yeah, dude, it'd be easy.
That's simple, bro.
I might just fly right there and land my heli on the roof of your building.
Dude, I mean, I think it has a helicopter pad.
I know. I had my folks build it.
Oh. Okay. That's where the PJ comes from. Okay.
Now, so what's something new that you're changing in 2021?
Something new. Definitely the micro habits, bro. Towards the end of the year, I kind of ended up slacking off because I was like, all right, it's the holidays. Everyone's everyone's chilling, killing. So I was like, all right, I'll chill and kill for like a little bit. It doesn't really happen often, but I think I'm gonna. A completely identity shift, you know, just like an entirely like new lifestyle, like waking up at like 5 every day, going on a run, not waking up, not checking my phone on those runs, like playing music from my watch type shit. Reading more. I don't read enough. Definitely squeeze some time in for that, and definitely gonna be more strict on the diet.
That's great,
because dude, ever since I went on the diet hard for like 2 weeks, my stomach has like no tolerance to meat. It's crazy. Like, I'll have meat, I'll be like, damn, man, like,
dude,
that shit hurts. But
that was just me on Thanksgiving.
Yeah,
like, I was like, why did I just eat that?
Yeah, it hurts. It literally hurts. But dude, and it all, like, one of the most important things to understand when you're going into like into a new year is understanding that you're the same person now as you will be like when the new year starts. So like, you kind of have to start disciplining yourself, not like insanely early, but like, you gotta have the mindset, like, before you go into it, like, all right, a change is approaching.
It's so hard for people to just flip a switch. Yeah, some people can just flip that switch, you know, get a whole new regiment and
I feel like most people can't, though.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
the thing. You really have to be most a different people. Breed to do that.
It's uh-huh. hard, bro. Like, Ty just flipped a switch on the vegan thing. He just said, fuck it, I'm vegan. And then he it was crazy.
Yeah.
Literally crazy.
I'm sure that was tough.
There's not, it's rare.
It was for Low-key. A week, and then I was just like, okay, I feel so much better, mm-hmm. so much more mental clarity and physically stronger too.
Yeah, well, you are a different breed, so.
Different breed.
I appreciate that, man.
Different breed. Pete, what are you switching up?
Well, I don't know. I kind of have a weird point of view, specifically about New Year's resolutions, because mm-hmm. it just seems a little bit arbitrary to me. Like what? How much sense does it make to wait till a certain day to change yourself? Like, why would you wait until January 1st to make all these changes? I mean, you could have made them last week, or yeah. you could have made them a month ago. Like, you could have made them a year ago.
Yeah, dude, definitely.
But in the spirit of changing ourselves, a couple things I definitely want to do is, kind of like what you said, the micro habits. I think getting back into a routine of reading regularly, because I've been reading really sporadically mm-hmm. recently, and I haven't read as much stuff as I would have liked to.
Same.
There's so much to read and not enough time.
Mm-hmm.
So it's also a good thing putting more time in towards that. Mm-hmm. I think...
Just prioritizing your time better.
Right, right. I think exactly. Spending less time doing things that don't pay off for me. Like, I yeah. remember I came home yeah. today in the early afternoon, and I had something I was going to do, but I completely forgot. I was going to like work on a song or something. I forget what it was. But I was on my phone, and I went on YouTube... to see if any of the channels I follow had posted something new. Mm. And I kind of fell into this little rabbit hole. And then like
it happens to the best one.
Yeah,
it happens to me all the time.
And like 20, 30 minutes later, I'm like, all right, well, now it's time to get to that one thing that I meant to do. So kind of just like procrastinating stuff like that. Just like catching myself when I feel myself...
your like intuition, like
it's all yeah. about but, staying conscious.
Yeah,
you know you can't
like,
do no, that.
Yeah, like noticing when those things happen.
Yeah, uh-huh. that's huge. That's actually huge,
dude. That's just conscientiousness. Like mm-hmm. it's like a skill that you need to develop over
yeah.
time.
Like being
it's
aware.
Not, yeah, it's not that easy. Like you really have to
dude,
focus
it's
on
hard.
Your attention.
Yeah.
Yeah, with like every single like tiny part of your day.
Yeah,
every single part.
Yeah, and then once you notice it. Doing the actual change is almost just as hard.
Yeah, because you have like, to remind yourself
sucks.
To do
like,
it.
Especially when you do things that you don't really want to do, but you know that you have to. It's so brutal. Like, the first mm-hmm. 10 minutes you sit down, like, to do something, it is just brutal.
Yeah. Dude.
Like, every distraction that you could possibly think of will enter
yep,
your head.
Yep,
and you have to kick every single one of them out before you can actually, like...
And just
when you do shit that you don't want to do, your subconscious just takes over. Because yeah. you don't want to be doing that.
Yeah.
So you're like, all right, autopilot. Subconscious, like it just, and then next thing you know, the activity that you didn't want
to
do is done.
Yeah, when I do something I like don't want to do, and like I know I have to, I tell myself, all right, I'm gonna do this for 20 minutes and then I'll take a 5 minute break. Just because like being able to look forward towards a break, my brain's like, all right, we can do this, dude. 20 fucking yeah. minutes, like, all right, we can fucking do this.
That's great to implement.
Yeah, yeah.
micro breaks in between the work. Yeah,
micro
yeah.
breaks, just fucking, because especially with people like ADHD, bro, oh, it's unreal, bro. Like when I was in math class, I'd be sitting there like, holy shit, like every day, like it never ended.
Math class was tough to sit through.
Yeah, yeah, dude, but knowing, kind of like little rewards, you know, for your good work, and, or if you don't do it, you give yourself an L for the day, and then no one wants to be walking around with an L for the day.
Yeah,
you know?
Dude, you hand yourself your own L, like take that responsibility.
You put it on like a board, put it on
the
board, and then
L today, my bad.
And then you just look
past tomorrow, it. Dub.
Dub, big dubs, big dubs. Yeah, Ty, what are you changing up?
Like you both said, micro habits for sure. Like making sure every shower ends in cold water.
Okay.
Waking up early at a set time every single day.
Mm-hmm.
Starting a calendar for the first time in my life.
Yeah,
like,
same.
Actually, a legit calendar where I log my day, like by the hour.
That's huge.
Each
that'll
day.
Be dope. That's huge. That'll
yeah.
be dope.
Jordan Peterson. He yeah. was the one that pushed me to do that.
Yeah. Like, that's a big change. I mean, you're gonna be. Infinitely more organized.
Making the bed every single day. I haven't done that in 5 years up until last week. And wow, like if you make your bed, that's already one thing that
you did
productive.
Right. Yeah, I've been doing it. Remember like, my mom was yelling at me for it?
You already got one thing done.
And then when you hit the bed, you're like, yeah, it's made.
Yeah, and it only takes like a minute and a half.
Uh-huh. And you don't have to like mess around at night with your sheets all fucking crumpled.
You just hop
and
you're in. Like, ugh. It's like, this is clean, this is nice.
Yeah.
Dude, another thing is cleanliness, bro. Like every single thing being clean, like, and the cleaner your room, the cleaner like your headspace is. Because, like, I walk it, because I'm moving, like, so all my shit's everywhere in my room. Yeah, so I walk in there, I'm like, oh my fucking god, like, we gotta get this situated ASAP. Like, it's fucked. But definitely, I used to just not give a fuck. Like, I'd be like, mom, I don't care if my bed's not made. Like, I'll just jump in it, I'm fine. Or, like, and it's just, once you start doing it, like, it feels good. You start
realizing, yeah.
It feels good,
yeah. Same with, like, cleaning your room and making things organized. Like, I often think about, like, if you're sitting in a room, mm-hmm. and you can notice something that isn't right, or, like, you want to change, and you go do that, you'll instantly feel better. And if you do, like, 20 of those things around your house or wherever you live, like, think about how much you just improved your life because you changed something to the way you want it.
Right.
And Jordan Peterson talks about that
a
lot.
Oh, yeah.
But I like control really of like your the environment. Idea. Yeah, I really like the idea of cleaning your room because then you just have clarity within your mind.
Yeah.
Nothing's all over the place.
Yeah, to kind of go back to the making your bed point, I just thought of this, but in my experience, every time I don't make my bed and I go to lay down in it at night, I always have to make it before I get in it. So it's like, if I do that at the beginning of the day, which I usually do, but sometimes mm-hmm. I don't, I save myself that 1 minute that I don't have to do it at the end of the day. It's like,
and you did that putting on a fresh start. Like,
yeah.
And then if you have to do that before you go to bed, like after your long ass day, you're like, I really got to do this right now.
Yeah. Okay. I just want to go to fucking bed.
Yeah. I mean, it really is like, who likes to get into an unmade bed?
I used to for a long time. Yeah. Really? I don't know what it was. I think it was just because I was lazy and I didn't want to make my bed. So I rationalized it by saying I just like getting it on my bed. But now that I get into a made bed, everyone likes getting into a made bed.
That's what I'm saying.
You can't cap. Like, I just rationalize.
You open that hotel room up, made beds.
That's what I'm saying.
You're pristine.
What if you open up the hotel room and the beds are just like completely like messed up?
I'd be pissed.
You're just like, yes.
Yes, fuck. I hate made beds. That just doesn't happen.
Dirty beds, yes.
Hopefully there's bed bugs, yes.
Stains on the sheets, yes.
I love itching with bed bugs.
Yes, give me. But, yeah.
Hopefully your bed at your house isn't like that, but.
Hell nah, come on. if that's your bed, we gotta have a talk. Serious talk. Dude, I'm so stoked. The bed is gonna be like, I'll wake up and I'll just see like the city lights. I'll just be like,
Yeah. Well, that'll be a nice what floor is it on?
19th.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, we up in that John.
So is it one of them Johns that's got like the bed and then like you've got the windows right next to your shit, so you just wake up to a view of the city?
It's like, say my bed's right here and then my door to get in my room's over here. The windows are like over here in the corner.
Ooh. Okay.
Yeah,
dude, that's still pretty tight.
My desk is going to go right in front of the window. Yeah, it'll be fucking fire. I'm excited for you guys to come down.
Yeah. Do you have any cool ideas on how you're going to decorate that shit?
Oh, yeah, dude. We went to IKEA. I'm dropping some racks at IKEA. Getting 5 bar stools, white ones, because everything's white.
Yeah.
Got a white Keurig for the crib. I'm getting so the tile is like white and it has like navy blue, like little rectangles in it.
That's actually tight.
So
that's already there?
Yeah.
That's
so tight. And then there's white marble counters. So my couch is going to be navy blue. I think it was navy blue, right?
I think so.
It was navy blue, so it's gonna be like, you know, just a little subtleness.
Yeah.
And then I think I'm gonna hang my TV, get like a no, I don't want to see the wires.
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe like a little tiny end table under it.
Yeah.
Well, not an end table, a TV stand.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of modern, right? They were modern. I can't even remember. But
it'll be tight.
It's gonna be bumping too.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm so stoked for you guys to come down.
You bringing the Xbox?
Yeah, just in case we lock down.
The box.
You got to.
My mom literally she's like, you're taking it? I was like, no, I'm not. And she goes, because if you lock down and you miss the boys, I'm not shipping it to you. I was like,
She's like, looking out for herself now.
Yeah, I'm just like, she's like,
yep, I know Alex. He's gonna want that Xbox.
Yeah. She's always right.
That's literally the same thing as making your bed in the morning. She's forcing you to take it now, so she doesn't have to do it later.
Yeah, literally, dude. I would literally come home and my mom would make my bed. I'm like, why did she do make my bed? Mm-hmm. But I'd be like, all right, bag it. That stopped when I was like 16, though.
So. I was gonna say that's saint behavior right there.
Yes,
she's a baller. She's a baller.
Your mom is lovely. That's lovely.
But yeah, I mean.
Go into this new year with a positive attitude.
Beautiful. Yep. It's going to be a good year. Don't think it's not. Definitely don't have the intentions of forgetting this year and starting like a new chapter of your book.
I saw this tweet about 2021 and I like it said 2021 like instead of one like WON because 2020 beat us all.
You get it. Yeah. All right.
2021. I thought that was pretty clever.
I like that.
That
is clever.
Yeah.
That is clever, thought.
But we're going to win 2021.
And so are you.
Big Dope dub. City, baby. Big dubs. Right, but yeah, it's been a fun journey of the basement potties.
My basement.
Yeah.
The basement potties. Maybe when we visit, we'll come in here, especially.
Yeah. Is that why you're wearing the Miami jersey?
Had to foreshadow. Wow, I've heard that word twice now in the past like, what? Day. Today. I haven't heard it for like 4 years. I heard it twice today.
Damn.
Foreshadowing.
Yeah.
Something is being foreshadowed.
Yeah, something. Something. Could it be the New Year's Eve party? Who knows? Who knows?
Come through. Come through.
All right, everybody.
Everyone's invited.
Our dude. I don't know. See? Don't take that seriously.
No. Don't take that. Pull up.
Okay.
For real, pull up. I'm not good.
All right. Well, fuck it.
All right.
Yeah. Cheddar
cheese. It's been real. See you in Miami, bro. Peace out.